Feeling hungry? Maybe you could go for a snack right about now, or a nice refreshing can of your favorite soda. Perhaps if you've got some change burning a hole in your pocket, a nearby vending machine would be a good choice. And trust us, there's no vending machine like this one. SCP-261 will give you a treat that's out of this world, or rather, out of this dimension. That's how this safe class anomaly earned its incredibly accurate name, the Interdimensional Vending Machine. It was first discovered in a dark alley in Yokohama, Japan. Japan is a place where you can find a number of strange and surprising things in vending machines, but nothing quite like this. The Foundation was first alerted to its presence after one of their web trawlers noticed some interesting chatter on Japanese online message boards about a magic vending machine. To these Japanese forum users, it sounded like a fanciful urban legend, a vending machine where you could get something truly fantastical if you have the yen to spare. But upon thorough investigation, field agents of the SCP Foundation discovered that the machine was no legend and brought it into containment. It's the kind of thing you wouldn't look twice at. An utterly generic black vending machine with no viewing window and a handwritten sign in Japanese that reads, "Out of order." But what the vending machine looks like isn't nearly as interesting as what it's capable of. When you insert your money into the machine, and it's important to note that it only accepts Japanese yen, the machine will dispense some kind of snack food or drink item. However, over time, the more the machine is used in a single day, the more bizarre the items it spits out will become. Foundation researchers have attempted to figure out how the machine works, but their task has been incredibly difficult so far. It doesn't appear to contain any snacks, and it doesn't seem to be made of any anomalous parts. Moreover, the machine simply won't work when the front panel is opened, or when any surveillance equipment is placed inside. In other words, it's pretty much impossible to look this gift horse in the mouth. Strangely, the machine is also capable of working without power, though when unpowered, the vended products are likely to become stranger much faster. But let's be honest here, you're not here for Vending Machine Mechanics 101. You want to hear about all the weird stuff that SCP-261 dispenses, and frankly, we're with you on that one. Lucky for all of us, this is one of the anomalies that the Foundation has truly extensive test records on, providing us with a highlight reel of some of the strangest, wildest, and downright most interesting snacks and drinks straight out of another dimension. Bon appetit! Let's start off nice and easy with some of the snacks and drinks that are not only edible, but also sound like they'd actually be pretty tasty. Like Pepsi Dragon Twist, a bottle of Pepsi soda with English packaging that tastes like dragon fruit. PepsiCo does not produce such a product, but honestly, we wish they did. Same for Dark Side Cola, a clear liquid that becomes jet black shortly after being opened, which apparently tastes like your average can of Coke, with a touch of spice thrown in. But hey, not everybody likes cola. Maybe you're a maverick, a rebel. Only a soft drink with a formal title can quench your thirst, and as such, you prefer Dr. Pepper. In which case, maybe the vending machine will furnish you with an interdimensional Japanese product known as Dr. Pepper's Amusing Straw. This spatial anomaly wrapped inside a whimsical Dr. Pepper branded straw seems to contain far more liquid than should be able to fit in the straw, about one bottle's worth of soda to be precise. A nice and convenient solution for whenever you need to get the fix that only an accredited doctor of Popology can provide. And if you fancy something from the more intoxicating end of the beverage spectrum, for 600 yen you can get yourself a rare bottle of Billy Beer. It's just the thing for those who weren't alive during the Carter administration, but still want to try brew that was endorsed by the younger brother of President Jimmy Carter. This anomalous bottle of suds, which was bottled in the 1970s according to its label, came with a note reading, "I had this beer brewed just for me. I think it's the best I've ever tasted, and I've tasted a lot. I think you'd like it too. Billy Carter." Drinking the beer got a D-class intoxicated for 72 hours. But what if you've just wet your whistle and worked up a hunger in the process? Thankfully, SCP-261 has some delicious interdimensional food to satisfy your cravings. So for starters, how about a tube of the Little Bakery 7-Grain? This small aluminum tube lets you squeeze out a blob of dough, which instantly rises and cooks itself into a tasty little loaf of bread. Testing has indicated that the bread is a little chewy, but still tastes completely fine. Not bad for a tubed baked good. How about some seafood to go with that bread? Then maybe for your entree, you can crack open a delicious pack of lemon clams. And we do mean crack very literally here. If you crack this bag of anomalous clams like a glow stick, they boil themselves. And once you open them, you're ready to enjoy a serving of tasty clams that have a slight lemon flavoring to them. Delicious. But if you're not that hungry and just feeling more like a snack than a full fancy dinner, the machine once put out the Lay's Bloomin' Onion. While it appears to be a normal onion, each layer of the onion is a different flavor of chip, leading all the way into the middle. Truly a gourmet snack with more layers than, well, actually exactly as many layers as an onion. And what about for those who are anomalously trapped in the year 2012 and are looking for a snack that is both tasty and meme-worthy? Well, you'd be lucky to receive a 700 yen bacon shirt. It's exactly what it says on the can, an edible shirt that both smells and tastes like bacon, and has no real side effects other than making you smell a little like bacon while you're wearing it. Though this could be a dangerous anomalous effect if you decide to walk through your local dog park while you're wearing it. We've been told it pairs well with the meat hat, teriyaki fedora, a size 64 trilby-style fedora made entirely out of teriyaki-flavored beef jerky. The object came flattened in a cardboard box bearing the tagline, "You can have your hat and eat it too," which is a pun that probably makes a lot more sense in their dimension. Still a bit hungry? Well, lucky for you, this magical vending machine has got you covered on dessert too. For 700 yen, the foundation was given an entire edible chess set, with each of the ornate pieces carved from what seemed like hard Pez-style candy. It's less checkmate and more check-ate. Another pun that I promise is funnier in another dimension. And for 300 yen extra, you might walk away with a candy robot playset. These are more hard candy components that can be put together to create functional, anomalous mini robots that move on their own, walking aimlessly and bumping into walls. But what about the full meal-craving consumer on the go? Who wants both a dinner and a dessert combined into one disgusting package? Don't worry, the interdimensional vending machine has got you covered. Just 400 yen can net you some delicious turdakochakan. These are balls of fried turkey filled with chocolate, a smaller ball of duck, more chocolate, and in the very center, a small ball of fried chicken. Even the labeling on the product describes it as having 450% of an adult human's daily recommended fat intake. We'll leave it to you to decide if this is a decadent treat worthy of the gods or utterly disgusting. Maybe you're feeling a little cheeky though, or you need the perfect comedic dessert for your bachelorette party. The vending machine has a candy direct from an alternate Korea, a tasty, if slightly too sweet, chocolate candy shaped like a certain male organ, filled with, we kid you not, liquid white chocolate. Perfect for anyone who has both the sweet tooth and the sense of humor of a 12-year-old. Okay, these were definitely all weird treats, but let's get really, really strange now. From the disgusting, to the confusing, to the inedible, to the straight-up deadly. If you're a bit of a sadist, perhaps you're the kind of person who enjoys watching their snacks dying in front of them before they eat them. For that, the vending machine provides an aluminum box with a viewing window and a red button on top. Inside are a collection of small furry creatures, each with a single big eye. When the button is pressed, the creatures inside are abruptly superheated, cooking them all to death. At that point, the box opens, and the creatures are ready to eat. We've been told they were crunchy, spicy, and tasted a little like beef. Maybe you're part of the slow food movement. For that, we recommend the delicious pile of slugs, which is exactly what it sounds like. This is a produce box, like the kind used for packing strawberries, except it's full of live slugs. There are both advantages and disadvantages to actually eating these slugs. The advantage is that they contain large amounts of vitamin C, E, and most of the B complex, which are all crucial to a healthy and balanced diet. The disadvantage is that they contain large amounts of arsenic, which will kill you. Though, of course, if you still have a candy-flavored death wish, but you prefer your entomological treats a little more leggy, then may we interest you in a fine caramelized spider for a modest 500 yen. It's full of deadly quantities of an unknown anomalous venom that's pretty much impossible to cure, but it's worth it for the sweet, sticky goodness that comes before death sets in. Another strange item dispensed by the vending machine was a tall metal aluminum canister with a ring pull that, upon opening, had a violent chemical reaction with the air and triggered a large explosion. Apparently, this particular beverage was never intended for oxygenated environments. The blast killed two researchers and resulted in the temporary suspension of testing. Though in a slight silver lining for this fiasco, the testing area did smell of citrus for a few days, which the janitors must have enjoyed as they cleaned up all the body parts. Another dangerous snack provided by the vending machine was a long tube of chips called Pringles, not to be confused with any other long, tube-based chips you may be thinking of. When the tube was opened, or popped, as they say, the D-class that the chips were presented to began compulsively eating them. When researchers ordered the D-class to stop, it seemed almost as if they couldn't. Regardless of the orders given to them, the D-class just kept eating. Even when guards terminated the D-class there and then, the corpse continued to eat chips out of the tube until it was physically pried out of their hands. But if all those salty Pringles had really worked up a thirst in you, perhaps you can wash them down with a delicious can of Cherry Bomb. An intense cherry-flavored drink dispensed by SCP-261 for 450 yen. When a D-class sampled this delicious soda, they commented on it tasting strongly of cherry. A few moments later, their head exploded with the force of a stick of dynamite, coating everyone and everything around it in gooey head viscera. The resulting cleanup took an arduous 6 hours. But wow, was that cherry tasty. And finally, why not complete this anomalous vending machine feast with a 1,000 yen papier-mâché piñata, resembling a dead horse that comes ready to use with a baseball bat? Everyone who saw the piñata fell compelled to beat it mercilessly with the bat, until candy began to fall out. Many in attendance claimed that it was the 1,000th gift unleashed by SCP-261, and thus warranted celebration. Once the dead horse was thoroughly beaten, all cognitohazardous properties ceased. There's a joke somewhere in there, but for the life of us, we're not sure we can find it. Oh well, maybe it's in another dimension. Now go check out SCP-978 Desire Camera and SCP-5031 Yet Another Murder Monster for more SCPs that are surprisingly useful.